Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. I'm Carshénah with Verse Films Productions, and you made it back to another edition of Kill Count right here on the channel. Stick around and let's count down. I'm breaking down the most accurate kill count for this 1997 fantasy horror classic gem. If you know anything about the 90s, it was a decade that horror forgot until Scream, Wishmaster, Leprechaun, and Warlock the Armageddon came along. Check out my decade's horror list for my annual Screamtober Month of Horror linked here. I'll be revisiting these aforementioned titles in later videos. Fear one thing only, and all that is, fear the djinn. Wishmaster became a franchise, spawning four Wishmaster movies. The last ended in 2002, called The Wishmaster, Prophecy Fulfilled, and of course, there was a change in lineup to the title character. The original movie was directed by Robert Kurtzman and starring Tammy Lauren and Andrew Devoff, currently streaming on Tubi TV, and is actually a fan favorite of mine personally. It's cheesy, it's got laughs, it's got creature and practical effects before CGI took over, and the one-liner puns are not to be missed. The idea of an evil djinn, a la a male I Dream of Genie, is actually a great horror story. Tagline, be careful what you wish for, is an understatement. The Wishmaster is an evil demon known as a djinn, who escapes from a statue, basically an evil genie that gets let loose on modern-day California. He can sustain human form if he can give someone three wishes. That someone is the person who originally awoke him. He has to collect enough souls to bring his evil brethren from the demonic plane to wreak havoc on Earth. There is someone from nearly every important horror franchise, and some that aren't so important in this flick. Cast and cameos include Robert Englund, who plays Freddy Krueger, Kane Hodder, who plays Jason Voorhees, Tony Todd, who plays Candyman, Angus Scrimm, yes, from 1979's Phantasm fame, he narrated the opening scene, Reggie Bannister, also from Phantasm, Ted Raimi, Evil Dead, and so much more, Chris Lemon and Dan Hicks. The list goes on with Tom Savini, who played a pharmacy customer who was uncredited. He's known for Dawn of the Dead, Creepshow 2, and From Dusk Till Dawn, Rico Ross, Frank Nicotero, who is cousin to the famed Greg Nicotero, the legendary special effects wizard for The Walking Dead, Hostel, Planet Terror, you name it, he's done it. Peter Lapis, Joseph Pilato, and yes, Buck Flower. Not to mention Harry Manfredini did the score. Peter Atkins wrote the screenplay and Wes Craven producing the film. This is an unreal cast and crew. A who's who of horror. Andrew Devoff has one of the scariest and harshest voices in horror of all time. He is the djinn and carries the film well. I felt there was a lot of attention to detail. From the camera shots when there were visions to the special effects, the backstory of the djinn, and just the sheer terror of the djinn himself. It really sucks you into the story. Wishmaster is really a terrifying cat and mouse game between the protagonist, who enters a reality with no knowledge of the rules of survival, and a cunning entity whose power seems to be omnipresent. The wishes are a very original way of creating scary scenes, so I feel this movie is unique in the horror genre. Devoff and Lauren were perfect for the roles, and I also like the cameos from horror legends. Now on to the kill count. There is a difference between confirmed on-screen kills versus people just fleeing in the background, falling down, or are turned into creatures. They don't count because we didn't see them die, but the ones we factually count are these. Opening scene at the Persian court, 1127 AD. Number 1, guy in the brick. Number 2, guy with the monster coming out of his stomach. Number 3, guy who turned into a red skeleton burst from his flesh. Four, same red skeleton strangling a guy. Now we turn the attention to America present day. Robert Englund is looking dapper without his usual glove of claws and his red and green stripes. And yes, that's Sam Raimi's little brother, Ted, who's always in his films. Number 5, Beaumont's assistant killed by the freight container dropping on his head. Number 6, Josh the gemologist in the lab, shards of glass from the opal and the djinn sucking the life out of him. Number 7, pharmacist convulsing from the bum's wish, and that bum is the famous Buck Flower. 8, Ariella, the structure retail saleswoman. And by the way, whatever happened to structure? I bought many a college wardrobe from that store. Number 9, cop shot by the perp by his own gun. Number 10, cop at the chair got shot. 11, detective in the blue suit, perp takes out his jaw. Number 12, the perp is finally shot to death by 6 cops. 13, the nighttime security guard turned into glass as the djinn walks through him. A Kane Hodder cameo. $14 to $200, Nick Merritt's mom. Her airplane blew up because of his beneficiary wish. So technically, we're gonna count a Delta Airbus A321. So that's 2 pilots, 6 cabin crew, plus 20 seats in first class, 29 seats in comfort, plus 142 seats in the main cabin, accommodating for today's standard, traveling from California to Florida. 201, Wendy Durley. The professor had her skin peeled by the djinn as he impersonates her to Alexandra. 202, Valentine, the bouncer, with a cameo from Tony Todd. Drowned doing the Houdini straitjacket in a tank of water trick.
As you wish. Houdini did it in 2.5 minutes.
203, woman turns to glass. Then we go frame by frame for this party scene to accurately count. And again, we're not counting people who flee or just maimed. We're counting actual bodies. 204, party guest in white jacket next to woman turned to glass. 205, party guest in black jacket next to glass woman. 206, party guest in polka dot shirt behind the glass woman. 207, party guest in gray long sleeve shirt. 208, party guest face disfigured by shards of glass. 209, party guest on the floor in paisley shirt by shards of glass. 210, party guest in gray stripes hit by statue snake come alive. 211, musician done in by his own bow through his mouth. 212, party guest beheaded by piano wire. Cameo by Robert Kurtzman, the director. 213, party guest on the floor drawn in by strings. 214, party guest firebombed by the fireplace. 215, party guest hanging upside down with monster flapping out of his chest. 216, party guest woman in green dress dead on the floor. 217, party guest man in brown dead on the floor next to woman in the green dress. 218, party guest woman with pearl necklace dead on the floor next to woman in the green dress. 219, Raymond Beaumont in the statue hallway. Cameo, of course, by Robert Englund. 220, security guard sliced by the sword. 221, security guard bludgeoned in the face. 222, security guard stabbed in the stomach. 223, security guard sliced by Jack the Ripper painting come to life. 223 with the airplane technicality. But Alexandra makes her third wish and everything goes back to normal as if no one died. So this very deceptive kill count is only 4. The 4 verified kills in ancient Persia at the beginning of the movie. All modern day kills were voided out. Thanks for watching this fun cat and mouse game. Until next count, don't forget to subscribe and hit those notification bells for the next one. I wish to see you soon.